Merry Christmas, everybody. Tonight we are going to celebrate how peace came to earth in the Christ child and how that peace also came into our hearts through faith. And we turn to the invocation, I will say that which is in the light print and the congregation that which is in the bold print. He was light,
coming into a world of darkness.
He was love,
coming into a world of hate.
He was life,
coming into a world of death.
He was peace,
coming into a world of strife.
He was righteousness,
coming into a world of sin.
He was hope,
coming into a world of defeat.
He was God,
coming into a world of humanity.
He is our Savior.
And we begin in his name.
Heavenly Father, Jesus was with you in the beginning, but we did not recognize him. He came into our world, but we did not welcome him. He came to his own, but we did not receive him. We are sorry for the sins of the world and sorrier for our own sins. Forgive us for not making room in our hearts for Jesus. Pardon our rejections of him and those filled with his light. Grant that we might spread his light and grace to give life to our world. As the angels told the shepherds that first Christmas Eve, do not be afraid. We bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Rejoice. Through Christ, we have peace with God.
Amen.
As we light the candles this evening, of course, the star attraction is the candle in the middle, the white candle in the middle, the candle of the Christ child. Better get this star attraction lit. Try it now. No. We'll pretend it's lit. Thank you. We now join together in our opening carol, Joy to the World.
Thank you.
Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that as we have known on earth the wonder of that light, we may also behold him in all glory in the life to come. Through your only Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Isaiah's prophecy from Isaiah 52, God reveals and humankind sees. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your watchmen lift up their voices. Together they shout for joy. When the Lord returns to Zion, they will see it with their own eyes. Burst into songs of joy together, you ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord will lay bare his holy arm in the sight of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth will see the salvation of our God. And we join together in the verse of the day. Alleluia. Alleluia. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Alleluia. And please stand for the Christmas Gospel. From Luke. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And please be seated while we sing our carol, Away in the Manger. please stand? And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." This is the Christmas gospel. Please be seated as we continue with our theme carol.
Struggle, where disappointment rules our lives. It isn't always easy, is it? always easy to smile from the tear, to shrug off the curse, to feel the warmth. At times life can be very hard. At times life can be very difficult. It can be anything but peaceful.
A famous poet in American society, in our world, in our United States, experienced this. And I'll give you a hint. He has a long name. Who is the poet to whom I'm referring? He has a long name. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. Right. In 1861, his personal peace was shattered when his beloved wife, she was named Frances, he called her Fanny, she was killed in a house fire. She was fatally burned. And in that same fire, Longfellow suffered disfigurement to his face because of the flames. And it was after that that he started growing the beard that we recognize him for. And also, a couple of years later, his oldest son, Charlie, enlisted in the Union forces as our nation was torn apart in civil war. He was shot. He was seriously wounded. And he spent months recovering in his home, his father's home in Massachusetts. And on Christmas Day, 1863, Longfellow wrote a poem, and it's called Christmas Bells. And two of the verses go like this. I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, and wild and sweet the words repeat of peace on earth, goodwill to men. And in despair I bowed my head. There is no peace on earth, I said, for hate is strong and mocks the song of peace on earth, goodwill to men. Out of this poem came the ancient Christmas carol, I Heard Bells on Christmas Day. And we'll learn later that this isn't the end of the poem. God saw to that. God saw to that in the birth of his son, in his son's manger crib, and on his cross, and on the crown of life, his resurrection. Tonight, we marvel once again how peace came to earth on Christmas Eve. My first parish was in Lincoln, Nebraska. And that's where the Nebraska Cornhusker football team plays. And any babies who were born on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day were given these kind of cute sleepers. They were bright red, and they had a stocking cap on. And on top of the stocking cap was a little N logo. Those sleepers were cute. The Christmas cards that have the manger scenes are beautiful. You want the dirty truth of what really went down on Christmas Eve? Listen to Luke. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Step inside a filthy barn. Feel the cold draft. Breathe in the smell. God wrapped himself up in his mother's womb, and he became a little baby. And that baby that Mary held in her arms, he had tiny toes, and he had soft skin. And Mary had to feed him and burp him and change him. That little baby required constant attention from mom and dad. And that little baby was the Son of God. They watched their son grow. They watched him grow from a tiny baby to a toddler, to a teen, and then to a carpenter. And as a carpenter, he earned a living building furniture and installing kitchen cabinets. But in all the time that they spent with their son, their oldest son, as they raised him in their home, there's one thing they never heard, or there's one thing they never saw in their son. They never heard a bad word come out of his mouth. They never saw a sinful act come out of his body, because not only was he true man, he was also true God. Jesus was a baby, and he was majesty wrapped up in humility. Because inside that true man was true God. Jesus was in every way true God, and in every way true man. I need a volunteer, and don't worry, I'm going to ask you two questions, but they're very, very simple questions. Who would like to volunteer? They're really easy. Would like to volunteer. Need to come up here. Tell everybody your name.
My name is Tom Lyman.
Okay. And when you look in the mirror, whose face do you see?
Tom Lyman.
Okay. Thank you, Tom Lyman. You may now sit down. That is Christmas. In Jesus, God tells us his name. In Jesus, God shows us his face. And as we listen to Jesus' name, we learn that peace came to earth through not only this unique baby, but as he goes on, through Jesus, the promised Savior. We listen to verses 8 through 11. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord." A king had a dream, and in this dream he saw justice holding in her hands the scales of life and death. And then in this dream, here is what the king saw. He saw humankind placed on one of the scales, and he saw a nest of hay placed on the other scale. And humankind's scale tipped down to death, and the nest of hay tipped up to life. And then the dream continued. And in the dream, the king saw a woman take a little baby and place it in the nest of hay. And then here's what happened. The nest of hay and the baby inside that nest of hay tipped down to death. And human mankind tipped up to life. My friends, you know what that is? That is the interpretation of the Christmas gospel. In fulfillment of the angel's message to the shepherds, we have peace. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. The baby on the nest of hay tipped the scales in favor of mankind to life. Jesus became death, and we became life. And as Mary held her newborn in her arms, she knew exactly what was in the cards for him. She knew what was going to happen to her baby who became a man and what lay ahead. Luke fills us in on that when he says, Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart later on, right? She said that. In the cards beyond the crib was the cross on which Jesus died. My sin is pinned to the cross. My guilt is pinned to the cross. My death is pinned to the cross. My hell is pinned to the cross. Yours too. When you enter most Christian churches, just like here, Shepherd of the Plains, one of the things you notice first is the cross. The cross is the most recognizable symbol of Christianity. And there's a reason that the cross is the most recognized symbol of Christianity. In fact, there are billions and billions and billions of reasons why this cross is the most recognized symbol of Christianity. And you know what? You are one of the reasons. Jesus took every bad thing in your life on his back on the cross, and he gave you forgiveness and the promise of eternal life in heaven. Mind if I ask you a personal question? How many of you ever got in trouble when you were small? How many of you ever got in trouble when you were a teen? How many of you maybe even got in trouble beyond that? Even though you sometimes got in trouble, even though you sometimes may still get in trouble, would your parents ever, ever stop loving you? And those of you with children, no matter what your children would do, even if your children were to break your heart, would you ever, ever stop loving them? The answer is no, because they're your children. God, through Jesus, is our Heavenly Father, and he will never, ever stop loving us because of the crib and because of the cross. And on Christmas, because of that love, what did God usher in? Enduring peace, verses 12 to 14. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." This peace that is proclaimed by the angels is often misunderstood. Why can't our world be a more peaceful place? The reason is because our world is busted by sin. And Jesus said that as long as we live on this earth, there will be trouble. And none of it is new. Whether it is the Delta variant today or the Omicron tomorrow, you can bet that there will be something else to take its place in the year 2022. Of that we can be sure. And so how do we react to all of this? We can choose to participate in the gloom and doom of the chaos all around us, or we can choose to be courageous Christians and to let our light shine and to share the peace that the shepherds shared. September 2, 1945, On that day, something very special took place on a battleship. And it was the battleship, the Missouri. And it was anchored in the harbor of Tokyo Bay. And a delegation from the Japanese Imperial Kingdom signed an unconditional peace surrender to the Allied forces. And thus ended World War II. Peace came into our world, but not for everyone. There were Japanese soldiers located and isolated all around the Pacific Islands. They didn't know the war was over. Every single day, they lived in fear. They lived in fear that they would be captured and killed by their enemy, who was no longer their enemy. For some, it was days. For some, it was weeks. For some, it was months until they finally crawled out of those hidden places and discovered there was peace in our world. Even tonight, as we sit here with the peace of God in our hearts, there are so many people who are just like those Japanese soldiers. They are in fear. They are in fear that they will be captured by their enemy, the devil. They are in fear of what stores in store for them down the road. We have that peace in our hearts. And that's the peace that we are to share with others. In the meantime, even as we celebrate this wonderful peace coming to earth and coming into our hearts tonight, remember that as long as we live on this side of heaven, sometimes it's not going to be easy. Sometimes we will struggle. Sometimes people we love will hurt. Life will sometimes be lonely, challenging, difficult. I told you I was going to come back to that poem, Christmas Bells, by Longfellow. He wrote a final verse. On Christmas Day, he heard the church bells ringing louder, and he lifted up his bowed head, and his spirit was filled with joy. And he wrote these words. Then pealed the bells more loud and deep. God is not dead, nor doth he sleep. The wrong shall fail, the right prevail. With peace on earth, goodwill to men. What made you come to church tonight? The obvious reason, because it's Christmas. But I believe there's more to it than that. I believe the reason you came to church tonight is because you truly believe what Christmas is all about. Christmas is more than singing Santa Claus is coming to town. It's singing Silent Night, Holy Night, Christ the Savior is born. Christmas is more than the gifts we give to each other. Christmas is the gifts that God gives to us. Christmas is more than this peaceful feeling of the season. Christmas is the peace that we have in our hearts. So long ago, so many nights ago, peace came to earth on Christmas. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. We now will continue with our offering, and during our offering, Kurt will sing a solo. And also during the offering, They will distribute the candles. Now join together in singing Silent Night, but before we get into the English verses, Kurt will sing a verse in German. Are you able to dim those lights?
Still and all.
We celebrate how peace came to earth. Please rise for our prayer. On this holy night, dear Father, we rejoice to hear the good news of great joy that a Savior has been born for us. For fulfilling your prophecies and in the fullness of time sending your Son to be our Savior, we give you our heartfelt thanks and praise.
Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
What a great mystery of our faith is this, that God has become fully human for our salvation. Even though he is the all-powerful Lord of all, he is wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger.
Help us always believe that this precious child was born as our substitute to be our Savior.
Amid our joy, we grieve for the many people in our world who do not know that Jesus has come to bring them forgiveness and healing. As the shepherds spread abroad the good news of the birth of the Savior born for all the world, may we also make use of the unique opportunities this holiday presents to tell others of what we have seen and heard concerning the child.
Grant that the true peace between God and fallen mankind may comfort all people.
Hear us, Lord, as we bring you our private petitions. As the angels sang out their praise, move us to sing out our praise to you today, every day, and every day, as the joy of Christmas remains in our hearts.
Glory to God in the highest. Amen.
And together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Receive with believing hearts the benediction of our Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with his favor and give you his peace. Amen. And we join in our closing carol. Seated, everyone. Thank you, all our crew, for assisting with us. Special thanks, Kurt, for the music and the singing. Thank you to all of you for coming. especially if you're a visitor. I'm serving as the interim pastor here, so I'm not sure who is a visitor or not. And also, remember as you leave this evening to leave as those shepherds did, sharing the peace that we have with others. There isn't any service tomorrow. We do have a service on Sunday, one service at 10:30. We'll really be celebrating Christmas Day on Sunday, so we hope you can join us for that. Again, thanks everybody, and may the peace of God be with you. Take care.